Good morning, YouTube. Today is the day of surgery. We are just arriving at the hospital. Check-in time is at 5:30. I'm a little late, but that's okay. So we're gonna go in, get myself checked in. They're probably gonna go ahead and take me upstairs, get me prepped. Surgery is at 7:45-ish and whatnot. So yeah, like my nerves are really high, my anxiety is up there. I wish I could have smoked a bowl before I came, but I couldn't. And I feel sick to my stomach because I can't eat or drink anything. So yeah, they'll probably be able to give me some ice chips, which will be nice, but we'll see. So yeah, I'll keep you guys updated with throughout my time here at the hospital and whatnot. Catch you guys in the next shot. Hey YouTube, so we are checked in, heading upstairs to get me prepped. Hey YouTube, so we are in the room that I'm in temporarily until they take me back for surgery. Got changed and stuff, took out my earrings. I'm just waiting to take out my labret in last minute because I don't want my hole closing. I've had this piercing for over a year now, almost 2 years or so, and like, don't want it closing. So, leaving it in until last minute. So, yeah. I'm prepped for surgery for the most part. They just gotta do IVs and all that other fun shit. But I'll keep you guys posted. Hey YouTubers, I'm back. Sorry I didn't record while I was still at the hospital and everything. I was very out of it when I came out of surgery. And I was very emotional and stuff. Which, I have that side effect, because it's my anxiety that and stuff that just overcomes me with surgery. So surgery is very traumatizing for me ever since I had brain surgery back in 2010. So anytime a surgery is scheduled, I have anxiety and everything coming out of it. I scream and cry, apparently. This is the second time it's happened. First time it was with me getting my top wisdom teeth done, and they pulled me out all screaming and crying at that time. This was years ago. Probably back like 2013 or so, 2012 and whatnot. And then today, I didn't have this problem earlier this year when I had my gallbladder removed, but that surgery was like on an emergency basis. It wasn't needing to necessarily be scheduled. It was scheduled but not scheduled, if that makes sense. Like, I was already in the hospital, like, and whatnot, and doped up on so much shit, like, I wasn't having to anticipate it for like a long period of time, like, oh, okay, the surgery's coming up on such and such date, you know, whereas the other surgery was like, boom, bada bang, it's done, and whatnot. So, yeah, so that was not a good experience for me. So now I'm at home, recuperating, in pain. Pain's not too bad right now. It's just, it's kind of a pain in the butt to get around the house, and whatnot. I've been utilizing my knee scooter, which is helpful, but it's also kind of a pain in the ass. I have a wheelchair. I have crutches if needed, and whatnot. So this is going to be a long healing process. I'm in this cast for a week, and then I go back next week. They're going to take this one off and put another soft cast on, and then go back the next week. They'll take that other cast off, and then the stitches or staples, whatever they used, and then put me in a hard cast. And then around week 10 or 12 is when they'll put me into a boot. So I have a long healing and journey ahead of me for the rest of the year, basically. I'm not able to do any weight on this foot, so I have to put like my body weight on my right leg and use my upper body strength and stuff. So it's mostly going to be made up of me just relaxing, watching Netflix, video gaming, and trying to get back in the mojo of things, but at my body's pace, because like my body is really swollen. Well, not my body, but my leg is really swollen and like, yeah, and stuff. So yeah, I haven't had to take any pain meds yet. I'm due for it, but I'm waiting. So I just don't feel like taking it right this minute. So if I do, it'll knock me the hell out. But anyways, thought I'd come back to YouTube and share this journey with you guys so far. So, yeah, journey for foot surgery was needing to be done because I had bone on bone, which was caused by two joints not separating when I was born. And as I grew, the bones merged together. So they had to go in today, break my foot, and remove some of the bone. And they put mesh and a screw in there to joint it together in the right way. And then they also adjusted my little skinny bone that connects my foot to my ankle. So they did all that. So I shouldn't have any more pain when I walk and stuff. Because before I would, if I was on my feet for long periods of time, I would be limping around the house, not able to really walk, and it was just interfering with my daily life. So that's why I went ahead and decided to have the foot surgery. I should have had it 6 years ago, but I didn't. So here I am 6 years later, exactly, and I have it done. Next year I'll have to have my right foot done. The same things with my right foot, but it's not nearly as bad as my left foot was. So I just hope this healing process is going to be smooth and everything like that. So, yeah. That's how it goes. My mom, my sister, and my brother-in-law were at the hospital with me. My mom was the only one that was able to go back there for before surgery and after for the recovery. But my sister brought me these really pretty flowers. Like, they're a variation of colors. They kind of look like a rainbow. They're really pretty. And whatnot. So I've had those out in the kitchen in a cup for a vase for right now. But yeah, stay tuned for future videos regarding my foot surgery follow-ups with my surgeon and everything else. Thank you for watching, and thanks for the prayers. If you guys have been praying for me and stuff, please like, comment, and subscribe, and hit that bell notification for future videos like this.